Hello everyone, welcome back to our scenes. Today we are going to learn how to draw ray diagrams for convex lens. Now before starting with it, see I have told you how to remember the table, how to remember the position of the image with respect to position of the object for mirrors, both concave as well as convex. For lens I have not done a separate video, but let me tell you that it's almost the same. The trick is the same what I have shown you for the mirror. For the first five, it runs in the opposite manner. So you can go through it, you can check it out. It's exactly the same. If you're not getting it, you can check my mirrors video and then you can catch up with the lens. So if you have still any doubt on this, you can mention in the comment box. I'll make a separate video on it. So now, see, for convex lens, we have got six illustrations. So we're going to do for each one. Before that, let me teach you how to draw this basic skeleton for convex lens. See here, the trick is almost the same. Once again, we are going to draw 15 centimeter line. See here, it's a 15 centimeter line. I'm going to mark the midpoint of 15 centimeter line, that is supposed to be 7.5. Then I'm going to mark 1/2 inches back and forth of the center point. Okay, the centermost point which I have marked, I'll name it as O. Now from the first point, I'll just keep my zero on the first point. Towards my right side, I'm going to mark 6 centimeters. And then from the second point to the first, I mean, that is, I'm going to keep 6 centimeters on the second point of my marking after O. And I'm going to mark 0 centimeters over here. I'm going to name this as 2F1 and this one as 2F2. This F1 and F2 is nothing but its center of curvature. Center of curvature, this is on one, for the first one and the second one. Now, okay, so can you see this? Between the first point and the second point, we have got 5 centimeter gap. So I'm going to mark half of it, that is 2.5. Similarly, for the last 2 points, I'm going to do 5 centimeter. I'm going to mark 2.5. So this one will be named as F1 and this one will be named as F2. Now, see here, my compass. I'm going to keep my needle on 2F1 and then see here, I'm going to connect the second point after O. That means after O, what is the first point? After half inch, whatever, half centimeter, whatever I have drawn, I'm going to take that and I'm going to draw a half circle. Same thing I'll be doing for 2F2 and the first point after O. And then again, a half circle. So whatever extra I have got here, crisscross pattern, I'm going to rub it out. So I have darkened it with pen. Now let's get started for the first one. For the first one, when the object is at infinity, my image is supposed to be at F. So here, I'm not going to show any of the F diagrams. What I'm going to do is I'm directly going to take a line parallel that is coming from very far away. I'm going to show it, a line parallel to principal axis. See, it's going to stop somewhere here itself, no further. Same thing I'm going to do at the bottom. A ray of light running parallel from the principal axis. Okay. So now what I'm going to do is from this point till F, I'm going to connect and I'm going to draw a line showing the
reflected ray of light. So this will be the exact point. So I'm going to show the arrow marks here. This goes this way, this goes this way, and after refraction meets at F. So my image is going to be at F2. It's going to be real and inverted, whereas only point size. For the second one, when the object is beyond 2F1. So now here, once again, as if you remember, I have been taking in all my ray diagrams, my object, this object length or height of the object as 1.5. So beyond 2F1, I'm going to mark here my object AB 1.5 centimeter long. Okay, so now, as usual, one ray of light is always supposed to be parallel to the principal axis. So I'm going to take that and then I'm going to make it pass through F on the other side. So I'm going to show this with arrow mark. The second ray of light. So in lens, you always have to remember that first ray of light is running parallel and the second ray of light will always pass through O, the optic center. And here there is no buts. Always in all the cases, it's O. So you not worry. And this is like, you know, your center of curvature. There is no, again, deviation from the point. So as you can see, I have got here an intersection point. So I'm going to draw a line to the principal axis here. This is going to be my A dash and B dash. So it's okay. So now see here, how do you identify here? See the size of the image here. It's around 1 centimeter, right? So my object was 1.5 centimeter. Hence it is diminished and real and inverted. See here, it's between F2 and 2F2. Now, for the third case, when my object is at 2F1, see here, I need same size, right? Whenever there's a same size, there is, you know, a kind of problem arising. But here, normally we don't have still. So, I'm going to keep my AB at 2F1. And the same thing I'm going to draw at 2F2. My image is supposed to be at TOF2. So, I'm going to draw 2F2 of the same size, 1.5 centimeter, A dash and B dash. See here, one ray of light has to run parallel, right? So I'm going to show one ray of light running parallel and then passing through F. See here, how I'm going to show it? I'm going to show this three dots connecting. The second ray of light has to pass through O. So see here, I'm keeping my A dash, O and A all in the same line and then drawing my line. So here your image diagram or the ray diagram is ready for this one. Then for the fourth one, when my object is between 2F1 and F1, once again, what I'm going to do is I'm going to keep it 1.5 centimeter A and B. As usual, what I said, we're going to take one ray of light running parallel. No differences here. Ray diagram, only the skeleton is different. Rest all is damn easy. Running parallel, passing through F2. Then the second ray of light will be passing through O. See here, I'm connecting O and A. And as you can see, I have extended it. See here, this ray of light is somewhere meeting. Right? So I'm going to draw this, I'll just extend it. See, some of the cases, especially this case, fourth one, where you need a slightly longer line. So I'm going to draw here, B dash, A dash. So I have got my image beyond 2F2, real and inverted. Beyond 2F2, real and inverted. See the size of the object, see the size of the image. So it is enlarged. Okay, so the last two ones are damn easy, nothing much to worry here. Okay, so in this case, when my object is at F1, so as sharp at F1, I'm going to draw
object A and B. And then once again the same thing, one line running parallel to the principal axis, and then passing through F2. Second ray of light will pass through optic center. So I'm not going to make these lines meet, I'm just going to draw dotted lines and leave. So they are not exactly parallel, they're somewhat bent than the actual parallel lines. That means they're going to meet, but somewhere at infinity, and hence it's going down and down. So from the principal axis, the distance is going on increasing. So it's going to be, highly enlarged, really inverted, but at infinity. For the last one, when my image is between F1 and O, I'll be drawing my 1.5 centimeter long object A, B. Once again the same thing, no difference. I'm going to take one ray of light running parallel and then passing through F2. The second ray of light will be passing through O. Okay, so now as you can see here, they are not parallel and they don't look like they are going to meet. So what we are going to do is, we are going to trace these lines backwards. So here exactly these lines, I am tracing them backwards. See, I have got an intersection point over here. So I'm going to draw this A dash, B dash. So I'm going to get my image on the same side as the object. My object is here on the side itself. I've got the image. They are going to be enlarged. Obviously it is enlarged and it's going to be vertically opposite. Virtual and erect. Since this is imaginary meeting, hence it is virtual and erect. I hope you have understood how to draw the lens diagrams. Damn easy. Only the thing you need to remember over here is the skeleton. The main skeleton is the main thing, and the positions. Otherwise, if you are perfect with which are the two incident rays, nothing is going to go wrong. I hope you like my video. Do subscribe to my channel if you have not yet subscribed, and share my videos with your fellow mates and get them to subscribe to my channel. Thank you.